In this video, we're going to factor trinomials by the grouping method when possible. So this means we're going to take a trinomial, rewrite the middle term as two terms, so there's four terms, and use the grouping method. This will also explain why the shortcut or sneaky method works, which I've covered in previous video, and why we use the product and sum. So let's begin with how we multiply using the FOIL method two binomials. Right, so the first term is going to be 2x squared. The outer term will be plus 10x. The inner term, and I'm going to write this as plus a negative 3x. And the last term will be a negative 15. All right, so here's what we want to notice. If you take the product of the two middle terms, in other words, the outer term and the inner term, 10x times negative 3x, and you compare that with the product of the first term and the last term, both times the product is negative 30x squared. And in fact, this will always happen. If you take two binomials, multiply it out in order, first, outer, inner, last, the first times the last term always equals the outer term times the inner term. Okay, so that's the first. The first times the last, and that was the outer and the inner, and that was your FOIL method. Okay, so the first times the last has to equal the same as the outer times the inner. So we're going to keep that in mind. And let's just finish by writing the answer now. So this is just an observation, everything I've written in red. 2x squared plus 7x minus 15 once I combine like terms here. So we're multiplying. You do first, outer, inner, last. The answer is 2x squared plus 7x minus 15. Now what we're going to do is deconstruct. We're going to start with 2x squared plus 7x minus 15, and we want to end up with the correct factors of 2x minus 3 times x plus 5 by working backwards. Okay, so let's say we're given this trinomial, 2x squared plus 7x minus 15, and we're asked to factor it, and the way we're going to do it is try to break up the middle term, the 7x, into the correct two terms that add up to 7x so that we can factor by grouping. So in other words, our goal is to write 7x as the sum of two terms. Okay? And what do we know? We know these two terms here will multiply out to be negative 30x squared. So we know we want the product to be negative 30x squared, but I'm only going to write negative 30 because I know they're going to add up to 7x, they must be like terms. So the variable part's x. So what really matters is the coefficients that go in front of x must multiply out to be negative 30. We also want to make sure the sum, in other words, when I add them up, I do get 7. So the sum is going to be 7. So this is why we do the 2 times the negative 15. We want two numbers that have that product, negative 30, and at the same time add up to 7. All right, so let's go through our usual method here. Numbers that multiply out to be 30 are 1 and 30, 2 and 15, 3 and 10, 5 and 6. Of course, you don't have to list them all if you already know the answer. And if the sum's positive, the bigger number must be positive. And since the product is negative, these have to be opposite signs. So the other number over here has to be negative, and the right combination is right there, negative 3 and 10. Now it doesn't matter where I put the negative 3 and where I put the 10. I'm just going to put the negative 3 here and the 10 here. So this is what we do by factoring by grouping. What we do is we write the original problem, and then we break up the middle term into two terms. so that now we have four terms so that we could do factoring by grouping. So now we're going to group the first two terms together and the last two terms together. Take out the common factor from each parenthesis, which will be x times 2x minus 3 and 5 times 2x minus 3. And if you got the correct two terms here in the middle, definitely you'll always get the same thing in parentheses when you factor. So now 2x minus 3 is the common factor that could be pulled out to the front. And we have x plus 5. So I've just deconstructed it, gone backwards basically. These are all equal, right? And that is factoring by grouping. You can see there's a lot of steps here, right? You start it with 2x squared plus 7x minus 15. You figure out the product and the sum. Then you need to rewrite this with four terms. Break up each two terms. Factor out from each two terms. Pull it out. So there's a lot of steps here. All right, so what's the shortcut? The shortcut is instead of writing all four terms here at this second step, okay, I'm simply going to just write out one of these terms, which if I pick negative 3x, I'm going to write instead of the 7x, instead of writing it as the negative 3x plus 10x, I'm just going to write out two terms. Because if I know if I write out the two terms and factor, see right here, I'm going to get one of those correct factors, which is going to be the 2x minus 3. So I take the 2x squared minus 3x, remember to put the x in, take out the greatest common factor, and there's my shortcut. So that if I was given 2x squared plus 7x minus 15, I automatically know that's going to be one of my factors. So that's the tricky method. Now what if you had chosen plus 10x instead of minus 3x? Again, you would take the first term, which is 2x squared, and write it with the 10x, right? And if you factor out the 2x, you have x plus 5. That's the other factor, right? So I didn't finish this first one here. Of course, I would get the other factor of 2x times what gives you 2x squared, negative 3 times what is 15. So I would have gotten the answer that way. Or if I would have put the 2x squared plus 10x together, done the shortcut method that way, I would have first figured out the x plus 5, correct? And then I'd figure out the other factor would have to be 2x minus 3. So no matter how you look at it, the correct factorization is 2x minus 3 times x plus 5. And hopefully some of you followed along and understood why I had to find the product and use the sum in order to do factoring by grouping. Why it makes sense comes from the original problem we did up at the beginning, where we notice that the first times the last term has to be the same as the inner term times the outer term. And then we discovered also, so those two terms have to multiply out to be negative 30. This right here is what I'm looking at. The 3x and the 10x have to multiply out. The negative 3x and the 10x have to really multiply out to be negative 30x squared, which it does. And at the same time, those two terms must add up to 7x. So that's the reasoning behind using the product and the sum and why the shortcut method works. Let's focus on this, though. Anytime somebody says factor, and they give you a trinomial, like 2x squared plus 7x minus 15, what you have to do is come up with the right factorization. How you do that is up to you. You can do trial factors, which is the way I do it, because I've done thousands, and I'm pretty good at coming right up with the answer, like this, on my first try usually, maybe my second or third try, but you could also use the product and sum idea, doing completely the factoring by grouping or the shortcut method. But what you always should do is check to make sure the factors you have, the signs, are correct. You need to practice checking your answer. So do first, outer, inner, last. Make sure that whatever you get for your answer, when you multiply it out, you get exactly the original problem. On the next video, I'll do a couple more using the longer method, factoring by grouping. Some people like to see all the steps. It's up to you whether you want to do that, the shortcut method, the trial factors method. Well, there's three or four different ways of doing it. Practice and have fun.